I'll be back.
What's up, everyone? Movie Mania Nick here. Last night, I went to go see Terminator Dark Fate. It starred Mackenzie Davis, Natalia Reyes, Linda Hamilton, Gabrielle Luna, and Arnold Schwarzenegger. And the director was Tim Miller. And actually, James Cameron, who directed the first and second Terminator movies, was a producer in this film. So this movie is basically about a hybrid cyborg human must protect a young girl from a newly modified liquid Terminator from the future with the help from Sarah Connor and a T-800. Okay, guys, so before I tell you my thought of this movie's got a lot, and I mean a lot, of mixed reviews. A lot of people thought it was okay, a lot of people liked it, a lot of people did not like it. So this is my final thoughts of this movie. It was okay. It was not the greatest. It was not the best. It was okay. The action scenes were outstanding. Great action scenes. The CGI was phenomenal. The de-aging was spot on. And you will know if you saw this movie what I'm talking about. In the beginning of the film. Those were great. Linda Hamilton. Coming back as Sarah Connor. She was badass. But there were some scenes where she said some lines. And it just. It felt like it was forced. But then there were also some scenes where she was being a smartass. And it was funny. I think Gabrielle Luna. As the Rev 9 Terminator, I think he did well. Arnold Schwarzenegger as the T-800, he did okay. I mean, he did what he could. He wasn't in the whole movie. And just to let you guys know, he didn't come back. He didn't really enter the movie until halfway through the film. So that's basically about an hour into the film. You didn't really see him. The girl that played Dani, she was okay. I wasn't too thrilled with her acting, per se. I'll just leave it at that. Mackenzie Davis, I think she did phenomenal of what she was given. I think she did good. She's a new and upcoming actress. I think she did great for what she did. I think the story was, it was okay. Not the greatest. But there were some scenes that were kind of edited that kind of didn't make any sense. I'll give you an example. There's one scene where when they're in a plane and all of a sudden you see someone, I'm not going to say who it is, someone's flying through the air because of gravity. And then you see the other person going after them and then they cut to something else and then they cut back to it and then they catch them. And it's like, well, how did he or she get there to catch her? Something like that. It just, the editing was a little off, I think, in my opinion. Some of the CGI, a lot of the CGI was good, but some of it was a little off. It didn't look real. Let's just say that. Also, there's some other things that the Rev 9 Terminator can walk through things, and then all of a sudden he's blocked by people or something, and then he couldn't get through them. That made no sense at all either. Like I said, there's little nitpicky things to this movie, and there's some great things about this movie. Like I said, it's okay, but not the greatest Terminator movie. But I did enjoy how they put some scenes into the movie from the original. The music was in there also, some of it. But also the storyline, you think that's what's going to happen, but it's not what happened. And what happened in the beginning, it's like, well, if that happened, what happens to the future? But it still doesn't happen. It's a whole time vortex scenario kind of thing. It's weird. It's really weird. It'll make you scratch your head. And also, when I was talking about the original movies, I like how in this movie, they did put some of the lines from the first and second movie into this, but said the same thing, but some of it was a different way, but she still understood it. But to me, this is like borderline if you want to go see it or not. To me personally, I would probably wait till it comes out on something else. Hulu, Netflix, Demand, or something else. I don't think I would waste my money in seeing this in a movie theater. But if you're a big Terminator fan and you've seen the other movies, by all means, go for it. But if you want a good thrill ride, a fun action movie, go see it. But other than that, I would probably, like I said, wait till it comes out in something else. Would not waste your money in a movie theater. And now it's time for fun facts. During filming, Tim Miller had to tell Linda Hamilton to stop smiling when she was firing guns. Also, James Cameron considers the film as a direct sequel to his own films, The Terminator from 1984 and Terminator 2 Judgment Day from 1991. In 2017, James Cameron had announced that the sixth Terminator movie would be the final film in the series. This film takes place in 2020. Linda Hamilton gets credit over Arnold Schwarzenegger in this film. And finally, the song playing when the Rev 9 crashes through the shed at a barbecue is the same song playing when the T-800 enters the bar at the beginning of Terminator 2 Judgment Day. And that's it, guys. That is my movie review for Terminator Dark Fate. I hope you enjoyed that. Smash that like button, share, support, hit that notification bell and notify you when my next video or vlog will be up. Also, check me out on Instagram under the same name, Movie Mania Nick. And as always, be excellent to each other. And party on, dudes!